Yo, 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 what it do, what it do? This is Toby with O-Line Security, and we are back with another lab from CertMaster. And this is All 4 Security Plus 701. Before we move any further, if you've been liking these videos, please don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe for future content. And please, please, please drop a comment. Let us know how we're doing. Let us know if there's something in particular you want to see. We would definitely love to hear from you. Now, in this lab, we are going to be performing gap analysis. All right, specifically system configuration gap analysis. What the heck is a gap analysis? A gap analysis is pretty simple and straightforward. We have a system here. The gap analysis is trying to identify the current security policies and settings on this system. What are its current settings? What are its current policies? What are the current security practices here? And we want to evaluate that against where it should be. Where the policies should be, what the settings should be, what the security controls should be. We are simply identifying where our system complies with our security policies and where the gaps are or where the deviations are. Why do you want to do that? So we can identify threat vectors. We can identify attack surfaces. We can identify, in other words, we can identify how or different ways, different avenues attackers can compromise our systems. Okay, that's just a reason why we would want to do the gap analysis, right? We want to see the deviations, we want to see the gaps before the attackers see it, right? Before vulnerabilities are exploited. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to perform a system configuration gap analysis. All right, so first things first, let's go ahead. Next, we're already on PC10, this is the PC we're gonna use. Let's open it up, Control Alt Delete. We're gonna switch users, hit other user, and we're going to use the admin user. I'm gonna hit this T button so it can type in admin. I'm gonna go to the password input field and select the T again so it can input this password. T stands for text, T stands for typing. We're gonna go ahead and log in. Sweet. First thing we're gonna do when we log in is check the system's build number. All right, we're gonna check the system's build number. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. We can talk more about build numbers later. We're gonna select this icon right here, type in WinVir, or you can just use, where is it at? We can just use this WinVir text field. Type that, hit enter, and you will see your build number right here. Right, that is the build number right there. It's the same build number that they have provided right here. All right, sweet. Now we're gonna get into the nitty gritty, the real stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and make sure I select all my checkboxes. Yes, I'm fine with skipping the other checkboxes. Sweet, now we're gonna open up PowerShell. Now please be careful when you open up PowerShell. We're just gonna hit this text button. Please do not use this version of PowerShell. Don't use ISC, use Windows PowerShell, just Windows PowerShell. But you need to right click and run as administrator. All right, yes, we're gonna select yes on this user access control, the UAC, right? Thank you for making sure that we are the administrator. So we're gonna select yes. Sweet, now what we're gonna do is this command right here. We're gonna copy everything from this D drive over to the lab files folder, right? That's what this command is doing. We're using the copy command. We're gonna copy everything from this location. In other words, we're gonna copy everything under the D drive, this D folder, this D directory, and we're gonna copy it over to C lab files. Sweet, that is done, right? And we can take a look at it from the GUI, right? Actually, it's right here, this folder right here. The same lab files folder is right here, right? This guy, all we gotta do to look at it from a graphical perspective is open that up, and you can see some of the files we've copied over. All right, now the next few commands that we're gonna do, we're gonna change directory into this lab files. We're gonna CD, which is change directory, and we're gonna CD into lab files, right? It's similar to opening up this lab files, how we have just done it here, but we're gonna do that from the command prompt. So if we just type this, CD is going to take us into the lab files directory. You see how we changed directory? We went from C Windows System 32 to C lab files. We changed folders, right? We can see the folder right here. We can also see it right here if we just type in ls. Boom, same content that is here is the same content in the GUI, the graphical user interface, the GUI. Sweet. Next, we are going to start, let's make sure we didn't skip anything, right? LS. Next, we are going to start extracting some of these zip files, like this policy analyzer file and this Windows 10 1809 file. They're both zip files, but we're going to unzip them. You could right click it and unzip it, but we're gonna do it based off of the instructions. Just hit this T. It's gonna go ahead and start unzipping that file for you. You will see that up here. That was pretty quick. We're gonna hit the next one and it's gonna do the same thing. We should see it up here. Haha, I caught it. And that is gonna start extracting all of those things. Sweet, and we can see it right here as well, right? Here's the policy analyzer folder that we just extracted. Here's that Windows 10 folder we just extracted. Gonna put this back down. Make sure we mark our progress, the policy analyzer. Okay, now we're going to actually start up the policy analyzer, right? You can simply hit this button to start it up, but I wanna show you something, right? I just want you to have good navigation between the command line and the GUI. So look, what we're gonna run is this command right here on PowerShell. But I just want you to see where what the command is doing. It's going into lab files, that's where we are now right here. Then it's going into the policy analyzer folder. Then it's going into this folder, policy analyzer 40. You can see that right here. And then they're going to execute this program, policyanalyzer.exe. That's this program right here, policy analyzer. It's an application.exe. Anything with this .exe, this is a file type, right? Just like you have .doc for Word documents, .pdf for PDF files, .xls for Excel file. .exe is a file type for Windows applications. That's why this type right here says application. All right, so we could double click this, but I'm not going to. I'm just gonna use this command right here. Now this is gonna open up the policy analyzer. This is what we're going to use to assess our gap analysis. We're gonna use Microsoft's policy analyzer. The policy analyzer is simply going to do an assessment of our current settings with certain policies, certain rules. Policies, rules, rules, policies. The policy analyzer is simply gonna look at our system, system A, and it's gonna look at some rules and compare the two. What are the differences? Does our system comply with all the rules and settings in a certain policy? But right now we can't see the entire application. Right, and they kind of explain that right here, right? If you don't see anything, make sure you fully maximize the screen. So that's what we're gonna do, right? This is the one time where I definitely have to go into full screen mode. We're gonna go into full screen mode. It's not fully in full screen just yet, so I'm gonna do it again. It's still not in full screen. So this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna close this out. I'm gonna minimize this, and then I'm gonna go into full screen and give it a while for it to render. There we go. I think that's what I didn't do during the last video. I didn't give it a minute to render up. All right, so that is in full screen now, and I'm gonna run this command again. I'm just gonna hit the up arrow on my keyboard. Boom, and now we can see the entire application. Sweet. All right, cool. Now, here, the next piece of instructions wants us to click on this. Before we click on this, this is policy rule set, right? We're going to select this to start picking the policies we actually want to analyze. So let's click this, right? We're gonna click this. Now the instructions want us to go to lab files, which is on our C drive. I'm just gonna use this shortcut. Lab files, and then Windows 10 version 1809. We want to go to documentation and just select folder, right? Once you get here, you want to select folder. I'll do it again. We're going to go to lab files. We're going to go to Windows 10 version 1809. Then we're going to select documentation, and then we're just going to hit this button, select folders. And now you can see a bunch of policies here. These are different policies we can use to compare to our system policies. Right, what policies exist on our system, what policies don't exist in our system. Before we do any comparison with our system and the policy, let's just look at the policy first, right? So that's step 16. We're going to look at the policy. Step 15 was just opening up all these files. Step 16, we're going to go ahead and look at the policy. All right, so which policy do they want us to look at first? It's going to be WS2019 final. That is this guy right here. So we just select this checkbox and then hit view, right? Hit view compare. It's going to load up this policy. Remember, policies are just a group of settings. Here are a bunch of different settings in this policy, a bunch of different settings, a bunch of different rules, settings, policies. Right, policy is really a list of rules, and here we have a list of rules. We have rules that are checking to see account lockouts. Hey, do you want to, and they give a nice little description here. Hey, do you want to track or audit, log? Do you want to log account lockouts? Yes, we want to audit, we want to log account lockout failures. Right, but if we scroll down to the examples they want us to use, lockout bad count. Here's a setting, here's a rule in this policy, right? The name of the policy is MSFT Windows 10 version 1809, blah, 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 blah. That is the name of the policy. Here are all the rules, all the settings in this policy. One of those settings is a lockout bad account. Here's a description of what what this rule is doing, right? Essentially, it is going to lock out after 10 bad attempts, right? After 10 bad attempts. And the value we have here is 10. You can set it to 3, you can set it to 4, you can set it to 5, but it's going to lock out the system after, or your account, after 10 bad login attempts, okay? And I believe that is actually one of the questions that we have to answer. What is the baseline value from the security template for the policy setting item of lockout bad account? The baseline value is 10. The baseline value is 10. Baseline is the template. The template value is 10. We can deploy this entire policy of 393 items with all of these baselines. These baselines are just the template settings. A baseline is a template setting. So the value here is 10. We can go ahead and put 10 here because that is the baseline value. You can change it, right? You'll see how they differ in a second. Here's another setting, minimum password length, right? The minimum password length is 14. This is a setting. This is a rule. That means on this computer, or not this computer, I'm sorry, in this policy that we're looking at, you are forcing users to have a minimum password length of 14 characters. This can change, but this is the baseline. This is the template. All right, so we're gonna put 14. All right, now they want us to go ahead and close the viewer, and we're gonna close out this policy that we're looking at. And now we're gonna compare that policy to our current settings, to our computer's current settings. So we're going to compare this policy. That means we're going to compare all the settings in that policy to the settings on our system. So what we're going to do, select the same policy, and this time we're going to hit this button, compare to effective state. That's going to compare to our computer's current state, and you'll see this is the baseline on the left, right? This is the template, the baseline values from the policy. On the right, this is our system's settings. On the left, these are the baseline values. This is what the policy comes with. On the right, this is our current system settings. If we scroll down to those same values we were looking at, lockout bad account, the baseline was 10. On this system, the lockout bad account is 0. There is no lockout bad account set here, right? We're doing a gap analysis. We're looking at the differences between our system and a certain policy where we want our system to be, or where you may want the system to be or comply with. This is a gap analysis. Right now, our system has a 0 lockout bad count, whereas the baseline has a 10. we have found a gap. We have found a deficiency. A deficiency. That was pretty tough. Now, this is something attackers could abuse, right? Or this is a vulnerability. This is a risk in our environment. We want to bring this up to stakeholders, people who can fix this issue, who can resolve this, right? Even the minimum password is set to 7 on our system, but on the baseline, it is set to 14. This is a gap analysis. This tool, Microsoft Security Policy Analyzer, is doing a gap analysis for us. We can go through, and I'd highly, highly recommend, y'all, take your time just looking at some of these policies, looking at some of these settings, y'all. Look at some of these settings and just read what they're doing, what they're logging. Just, you can even start with the ones that we're using in this lab, right? Just look at it, get familiar with it so you understand what's going on, right? The minimum password length, we're setting them, this setting, this policy is setting the minimum password for users. Okay, the policy is 14, but the system is 7. There's a gap here. There's some differences here that we got to remediate, right? The lockout bad account, the policy is set to 10. Our system is set to 0. That's pretty bad, right? At least set it to 3. Here's a gap here. That's something that needs to be that needs to be addressed. Okay, so we've done this. We've compared the effective states. Policy viewer, scroll down to the bottom of the list. We've done this. Is PC10 in compliance with the security template based on the gap analysis results? The security template, the baseline that we're using, PC10 is not, right? It is not in compliance. Obviously, we have 0 lockout bad account. We have 7 lockout bad account. This is how you can identify if your systems are compliant, by doing a gap analysis. This is how you can identify some security vulnerabilities, by doing a gap analysis. This is why you would do the gap analysis, so you can identify these things. It's not just going to be magically thrown at you. It's not going to be magically presented to you. You have to find them. You have to know what to look for. You have to know the data to collect and analyze to do your gap analysis. Right here, we're simply analyzing our system configuration. Hence the name of this lab, Perform System Configuration Gap Analysis. There are different types of gap analysis. All right, let's go ahead and click that. We're going to go to the comprehensive questions. Performing gap analysis forces systems into compliance. That is false. It doesn't force them into compliance. We're able to identify if they're not compliant, but it doesn't force them into compliance. Gap analysis is a process that identifies how an organization's systems deviate from those required or recommended by a framework. Yes, this is true. When should gap analysis be performed? After significant time has passed? Yeah, we want to do a gap analysis if, you know, 3-6 months has gone by. We want to see if the system is still compliant. When decommissioning legacy hardware? Probably not, because we're getting rid of the system. When meeting a new industry or legal compliant requirement? Yeah, we want to make sure we're compliant. When first adopting a framework? Yes, we want to make sure we're compliant with that framework. What is the purpose of gap analysis? Discovering the differences between the intended or expected config. We want to see the differences of what we have compared to the configs that we want to comply with. Which of the following statements is false in regard to gap analysis? Some variations from a baseline are less secure. That may be true. Some variates from a baseline may be more secure. That may be true. A single security template is sufficient to analyze all systems. This is absolutely false, right? A single security template is not. That means a single security baseline, right, is sufficient to analyze all systems. That means this baseline is sufficient to analyze all systems. This baseline alone, this baseline alone, this baseline alone, this baseline alone. No baseline alone, just on its own, is enough to analyze all systems, right? There's going to be other factors that get taken into consideration, right? There may be other baselines, other configurations, other policies. Maybe you take into consideration the results of a vulnerability scan, your endpoint configuration, your endpoint security, your network security. There's so many other factors that get taken into consideration. But here, what have we done? We have analyzed, we have done We've analyzed the results of a gap analysis. This is a use case scenario. This is a use case tool. Please go over this lab over and over and over again. Don't just one and done the labs, please. Doing the lab once is not going to help you succeed. Doing it twice is better. Doing it three times is even better. Doing it four, five, six, seven times, you are setting yourself up to win. Everyone in our Security Fundamentals Academy, please make sure you are not one and done in these labs. Please make sure you're asking every single question that comes to mind. YouTubers, please let us know if you have any questions. You can drop that message, drop your questions on as a comment on the YouTube channel. We would love to get to you. Please don't forget to like and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more content. We love having you here and can't wait to see you in the next video. Peace.